بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الفاتحة لحضرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وسيد الشيخ في الدين عبد القادر نور السرائر الحسني الحسيني الجيلاني رضي الله تعالى برحمتك أرحم الراحمين والحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله الإسلام الحمد لله رب العالمين هو الأول هو الآخر والظاهر هو الباطن وحده لا شريك له إله واحدا لا نعبد إلا إياه وأفضل صلوات الله وأنما بركات الله وأتم تسليمات الله على خير خلق الله ونور عرش الله وزينة فرش الله عروس مملكة الله إمام حضرة الله مطلع أنوار الله ومخزن أسرار الله ومرعة جمال الله ومشهد كمال الله وروح جسد الكونين وعين حياة الدارين صاحب قاب قوسين المزين بكل زين جد الحسن والحسين مولانا للمولى الثقلين وجوهر الشريف الأبدي ونور القديم السرمدي المحمدي سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا وملجانا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذرياته وأهل بيته وابنه الكريم الغوث الأعظم الإمام الهمام وحزبه وبارك وسلم أما بعد فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى في قرآنه العظيم وختامه القديم أولئك الذين أنعم الله من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين ويقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في شأن حبيبه المبارك إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد ما عندك من العدد في كل لحظة ولمحة من الأدب إلى الأبد وآله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم علماء الكرام أئمة brothers and sisters in Islam السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I would like to thank the Sunni Ulema Council for honoring me here tonight. And it is indeed a great pleasure to be here to commemorate a very important event, and that is the Yawm or the Urs Sharif of Afdalul Bashar Ba'd al-Anbiya سيدنا ومولانا أبا بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى I am not an eminent personality as it was exaggerated. I am an inferior mendicant, an elementary scholar of Islam, trying to understand it more so in the mystical language. So what little I had accumulated in the few days to present, to commemorate this auspicious occasion, I would like you all to partake in it. I am an imam in a masjid that is linked with a Muslim cemetery and graveyard. And there for 23 years, and I know what is the environment to stay around by the Kabastan. And I don't want to experience it here. So I want you to key me up, and the only way you can key me up, please put off all your communication systems. We don't want any disturbance. And the moment you feel bored, well, I don't know what is my time limit. Marring anything. As soon as my time is up, the Sayyid will signal to me, or any one of the officials can signal to me, then I will terminate. For you to assist me to give you a good discussion on the personality of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq, you must glorify Allah or send the ruh in the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like anything, say subhanallah. Now, we are destitute, we are poor, and lots of us are spiritually bankrupt as well. So we need some sort of wealth to take back with us when we go to the Qabr. The beloved Habib Sayyidina wa Moulana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states, you know, when he states, it is the highest perfection of truth, the highest order of sincerity, where there is no avenue or dot of doubt whether it is true or not. You believe in that? وَمَا يَنْتَقُوا عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِلَّا وَحْيُ يُوحَىٰ. Allah testifies, my Nabi only speaks that which he receives as a wahi from Allah. The Quran says. So when the beloved Habib speaks, he is speaking the words of Allah, and as Allah orders him to speak, he will say it. And whatever tone Allah ordains, he will express it. So beloved Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states, one who glorifies Allah says Subhanallah once. Anyone, any Muslim who says Subhanallah once, Allah plants for him a tree in Jannah. Once you say Subhanallah, Allah plants for you one tree in Jannah. But if your tree is in Jannah, you want to go there. Will you go there or not? But my car is parked outside. Then it can be somebody else's property, but my car is parked there. I have to go there and take it. My car. The tree is yours. Sasta soda. Sasta soda. So cheap, where would you get a tree in Jannah? Where would you get it? So when I speak, and when you feel inspired by the incidents or by the Quran and Hadith, you must express it. Don't just sit there and look at me. Express it, because a Muslim is a practical, he is a practical human being. He reacts. Islam and Iman is a spiritual entity, and it is touched when any spiritualism is heard. So you say Bismillah. Because I am going to take you into a very, very, very secret dimension.
up, I'm there with you. I will take you in a very secret dimension. So durud padho, subhanallah kaho, nara wagara mat lagao. You confuse me. Say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, glorify Allah, say, read durud on the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ye waada hai aap logon ka? Theek hai. Every government requires, every country requires a government. No country can operate if there's no government. And in the government, there are different departments. So the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has departments. You know, rain doesn't come to you like you say, Allah sent the rain. It's very easy to say. What happens when the rain comes down? How does it come down? How does the clouds come to you? You go one day is it's cloud, other day is no cloud. Then not all clouds give rain. Sometimes the cloud may pass by, and sometimes the cloud stands still there for a whole week and it rains. It's easy to say Allah sends rain. It's easy. But what takes place in the background? I'm going to take you behind the scene. What takes place? You know, you buy a car, you buy a Mercedes-Benz, oh, mashallah, subhanallah, so nice car, this. But what does, how much of work is put into it, how many hours and how many people, what programs are used to create that car? So let's speak about the rain. We'll give you an example and then we will go ahead. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala comments, Yaqadul Barq, in his tafsir. You know Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas? He's from the Ubadana'i Arba, the four giant Abdullahs of the Sahaba fraternity. He is known as Ra'isul Mufassireen. He was taught personally the tafsir of the Quran by the beloved Habib Sayyidina Moulana Rasulullah Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas. He comments on Yaqadul Barq. Barq means lightning or light. He comments on that and he speaks about rain and he speaks about lightning and he speaks about thunder. Don't worry, I'm not deviating from my subject. He says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed an angel, farishta. Allah ne ek farishta mukarrar kiya. Badalon par uska tasarruf hai. He is in charge of moving the clouds. His name is Barq. And the lightning that you see is the lightning of the whip of this angel. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu. The thunder that you hear is the tasbih of the angel. Tasbih. What is most amazing, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas says, do you know what is the size of the angel? Wo kitna bada hai? What is the size of the angel? He says, not bigger than a honeybee. It's not bigger than a honeybee. Garaj sun ke aadmi ki rooh kaap jaati. When you hear that thunder, it can terrify you. That is now the qudrat of Allah appointed this angel. And when the cloud is ordered to release the water for rain, it is stated that if it comes down in the volume that it leaves the cloud, and if it falls on your head, it will burst your head.